What's up, y'all? It's Demogini, and it's time for another one. So I just got back from watching Deadpool 2, and I'm not going to do a review right now. I'm going to do that tomorrow. I was actually going to do it today, but, during the day, I was seeing a bunch of things on my feed, and, articles popped up on my phone, and it's talking about Lando. Lando. Lando's hot right now because obviously you got Solo coming out. So a couple days ago, they had the whole Lando might be the next a Star Wars story, which was debunked. Said it was an error in translation or whatever. Basically Kathleen Kennedy saying that she was wouldn't mind doing a Lando movie sometime in the future. Okay, whatever. I think it'd be kind of tough to do a Lando movie like that unless you want to go and create more stuff around him or whatever, but that also falls under, hey, again, you're still using from the past, although you wanted to kill the past. But along with killing the past, let's try to warp the past too, because here's the thing that really stood out, and this is why I was gonna do the Deadpool review, but I stopped with that. Here we go. We have a bunch of articles that come up, and let's talk about Lando Calrissian is pansexual. So, a bunch of articles are up here. You got USA Today, you got 09, whatever that thing is, and then you have The Verge. The Verge is what I want to take a look at because it kind of baited you in, and I'll tell you how it baited me in a little bit, because it says Lando Calrissian's newfound pansexuality is bullshit. So I was thinking, okay, well, let's see what they got. They're going to try to step outside of the agenda box. But here's the subtext to that. If you're not going to make a character explicitly queer on screen, don't expect brownie points. So before we get this out and go super crazy, I don't care what somebody does in their bedroom. If you're gay, you're queer, bisexual, you like Martians, aliens, I don't care. It's not in my house, it's not me doing it, whatever, if it's a family member of mine or whatever, I don't care, it's just not my business to be worried about what somebody does in their bedroom. The issue I'm having is two things. Why you gotta constantly want to change something from the past, and why is it so important? Why is it? Because and I will put this article in the description, obviously, so you can check it out. Because I'm not going to go through the whole thing because it kind of pissed me off a little bit. Because what the article entails is basically saying, well, we definitely need to have a queer LGBTQ representation in movies. My thing is, why? Especially if it's not an established, if that wasn't an intended character arc or position of that character, why do you have to? Why is it so important for you to force feed that into something? Because there's in no way did you see Lando being pansexual. He was hitting on Leia. You didn't see him hit on Han. You didn't see him whatever dude or kind. In Empire Strikes Back, he was hitting on Leia. That's just how it was. He was hitting on Leia. And if you really want a LGBTQ character, make your own. You can add another character in, like how you added Rey, how you added Finn, how you added Poe, how you added Vice Admiral Holdo. Add a character in, make that character a main character. Ryan Johnson, since you want to do this new thing that you got going on, make your main character LGBTQ. Don't change a character that is pre-existing. For what? To have representation? Here's the deal. Clearly, if you could tell I'm not a white male, I don't need representation in every single movie. Is it nice to have? Yes, it is. Don't get me wrong. It's nice to have representation in movies. But guess what? I don't need a movie character, a fictional character, for me to know about my culture or have pride in myself. That's what my family's for. That's what my father's for. That's what my mother's for. My uncles, aunts, cousins, all that. That's where you're supposed to get that. That's supposed to come from your family. It's not supposed to come from external. If you need something to be external for you to get your pride out, then your pride is false. It is based off of falsehood, because these characters are fictional characters. They're not real characters. So that's just me. So if I don't need a movie character to represent me for me to have pride in myself and my being as a person, then that's what really frustrates me the most, is that why is it that you have to push something into something that doesn't need to be there? And that goes with the whole agenda that was going with the Last Jedi and the entire sequel trilogy, and since Disney bought Lucasfilm in general, has been some sort of agenda driven scenario going on in the entire mix. And then, you get sprinkles of that all over the industry too, which is crazy to me. Because again, like I said, if you have to get your pride and your respect for yourself and all that from a fictional character, what does that say about you? You don't have something in yourself, you know? What is it missing with you? But I'm getting on some other things too. But again, I think this whole thing where trying to push like what somebody's doing in their bedroom is just ridiculous. If a character was originally intended for that, great. If you want to make your own character, great. Again, you guys don't want to do the past stuff. Rian Johnson, there you go. Here's your thing right there. Make your main character LGBTQ. There you go. You don't want the Skywalkers to be involved? Great. Since you're trying to figure out what Star Wars is, I just helped you out. There you go. Your first character that you have for your new trilogy coming up is an LGBTQ character. Granted, again, you're using Star Wars for your own soapbox, but whatever. If it's not a pre-existing character, I'm cool with that. Like I said, I have no problem with anybody doing whoever they want to do, being whoever they want to be with. That is not my issue. My issue is stop trying to change things to fit your narrative. And again, think about this. Anybody out there who has a problem with this, the not having, representation, think about yourself inward for yourself for a second. Why do you need an external representation for you to feel some kind of way about yourself? That should already be there. If you are an adult and even if you're a young adult, teenager, if you're missing that means somebody didn't do something right in your life, because it shouldn't be coming from a movie, and it shouldn't be coming from characters or comics or anything like that. Like I said, is it nice to have that? Sure. But again, I'll say it 100 times, Luke Skywalker was my favorite character in Star Wars. And obviously, I'm not a white man. So, you don't have to have quote-unquote representation for you to like a character. But anyway, let me know how y'all feel about that. I'll catch y'all later. Peace. So